Hi everyone, this is Alex, and I am the Global Business Development Manager at Round. The Using OmniOne series aims at highlighting amazing projects, leveraging the OmniOne platform to build the next generation of authentication and identification technology. Among these projects, I am pleased to introduce the mobile ID card service for public officials that has been built on OmniOne. Prior to deep dive into this use case, I will first introduce Round, the company that developed OmniOne. Round is a leading ICT company publicly listed in Korea that provides security products and solutions, as well as ICT security consulting services to over 500 customer organizations that accounts for more than 30 million users. Round is a leader in biometric authentication technology in Korea, covering 80% of the financial institution's needs with its biometric product, OnePass. Its commitment in the biometric space worldwide is also reflected by its involvement in the FIDO Alliance as a board member company. Round is also a pioneer in next-gen authentication technology, as reflected by its involvement in the ADI Association as a co-founding member. ADI Association is an open industry association created to drive the development of a standardized, interoperable framework for decentralized identity. Through this association, Round is actively contributing to the establishment of trust and accountability in digital identities. Next-gen authentication technology and biometrics authentication technologies are among the solutions provided by Round. The company also provides a broad range of other products and services, from mobile security to security intelligence with its white hat. Among these products, we will focus on OmniOne, the decentralized identifier-based platform that has been leveraged in the mobile ID use case. Mobile ID is a public project conducted by the Ministry of the Interior and Safety. The Ministry of the Interior and Safety, also known as MOIS, is a branch of the government of South Korea responsible for national administration, management of government organizations, and e-government. This is actually the ministry in charge of the digitization of government-issued IDs. To have a better understanding on the mobile ID card service, let me introduce the problem that it solves first. Mobile ID service comes from the need to find a secure and convenient alternative to old-fashioned physical plastic ID cards while easing experience of users in their daily life. In particular, physical ID cards can be lost easily. In the past 5 years, the number of reissues due to the loss of resident registration cards reached 7.26 million cases in Korea, resulting in a total cost of 50 billion Korean won for reissuing these cards. Not only you can lose your ID card, but also you can get it stolen, involving the risk of impersonation, as the thief can leverage your card to get access to your office building. Also, the thief can use the personal information noted on your card with malicious intent. For addressing these pain points, the government introduced the idea of a mobile ID in its Digital Government Innovation Promotion Plan, announced on October 2019. Mobile ID corresponds to a digital version of the identification card. The need for rolling out physical IDs to digital format has also been pushed by the COVID-19 that accelerated the entry in the non-face-to-face era for businesses. In addition, the government, through the MOIS, was looking for modernizing its administrative authentication systems to build and enhance a trustworthy e-government working environment, while enhancing privacy by design by eliminating public officials' concerns about privacy that may occur in the process of using their ID cards. In this regard, when the MOIS looked for a technology to build the mobile ID card for public officials, self-sovereign identity was one of the main criteria that the selected technology had to enable. Such requirements could be addressed through the use of a blockchain-based decentralized identity platform. Among the solutions that have been proposed, OmniOne, developed by Round, has been selected in the public offering for deploying the mobile ID underlying decentralized identity framework. OmniOne is a standard-based DID platform aiming at enhancing convenience and security of users when accessing services while facilitating the job of ID verifiers. OmniOne service flow follows the global standards and is based on three main components: user, issuer, and service provider or verifier. In this use case, users are Korean public officials and local government officers, such as the city of Sejong government officials. The issuer is MOIS, the ministry I mentioned previously, and identity verifiers are MOIS, Sejong City, the National Library of Sejong, a bank that also participates into the use case, and shopping mall. The flows below provide an example on how this OmniOne-based ecosystem works. At the bottom left, the MOIS issues a mobile ID to a public official. Upon issuance of the mobile ID, the issuer will store the issuance information on the OmniOne-based network. The public official will store his mobile ID on his device through the mobile ID app. When he wants to apply for a loan at bank, the public official will submit his mobile ID through the related app to the bank. The bank will be able to verify the authenticity of the user by using the mobile verification app that will enable you to check on the blockchain if the information has actually been issued by the issuer. Upon verification, the bank will be able to identify the user and continue the loan process accordingly. Deploying OmniOne provided public officials with an integrated on and offline authentication model based on DID, an alternative to the existing physical ID card for public officials, a simple login environment using DID-based mobile public official ID card, and a convenience and security when accessing to a variety of services as reflected in the next slide. So with DID-based mobile ID, public officials can easily access to the office by tapping their phone on the entrance gate of the building, either using NFC or a QR code module. They can also access to the affiliated restaurants of their office buildings. They can also conveniently access to their office computers and get access to their email, government office work portal, video conference softwares, mobile messengers, etc. In this regard, mobile ID enable public official to easily log in securely just by running the mobile ID card app and scanning QR code that appears on the website of the government, reducing the hassle of entering ID and password. They can request certificates such as proof of employment or certificate of experience. They can also access to National Sejong Library and use its services. And in the future, there will be plans to enable them to rent public bicycles or to get access to specific service from bank as mentioned previously. The OmniOne-based mobile ID card for public official is in use since January 2021. There is a short video reflecting how it can be used currently. Only one mobile ID is currently in use. As of the end of April 2021, out of the public officials that can use the mobile ID, 10,434 applied for it and over 9,000 were issued. An official from the government also expressed that the mobile ID card has a high level of satisfaction in use, including the online authentication function. This is actually a huge step for a nationwide adoption of a decentralized identifier technology, as MOIS is a branch of the government of South Korea responsible for e-government. One of the purposes of the mobile ID for public officials is to actually serve as a pilot project before the introduction of a digital ID card for the public. This project takes part of a multi-step plan aiming at eventually providing digital ID to anyone living in Korea. Through this mobile ID card service, the government is applying first the technology on a limited scale, enabling him to find and improve problems and vulnerabilities that arise while verifying the level of convenience and security of this new means of authentication. Therefore, mobile ID has been introduced first to 15,000 government officials at the Sejong government complex and at the Seoul government complex from January of this year. Then, the Ministry of the Interior and Safety will expand the issuance of mobile ID card to 200,000 public officials by June of this year. Following the mobile ID success, MOIS plans to build the mobile driver's license using the same underlying technology and to provide it to the entire nation by next year. Starting with the driver license, mobile ID cards will then be expanded to 5 types of IDs, including the disabled registration card by next year, the national merit card in 2023, the youth card in 2024, and the alien registration card in 2025. The success of mobile ID can be explained by the underlying technology, OmniOne. OmniOne is the Korea-first DID-oriented platform based on expertise, know-how, and use cases built in the area of cybersecurity and authentication technology. It provides reliable and easy-to-deploy enterprise solutions while ensuring high performance. OmniOne is a pioneer in the DID industry in Korea that has already been adopted by a number of public institutions and financial organizations. Consequently, it has not only been used in the mobile ID use case, but also in a number of projects needing decentralized identity. OmniOne is a cutting-edge authentication technology enhancing simple and secure identity verification systems through FIDO biometric support. OmniOne services are based on EOS protocol, ensuring a high degree of scalability as the protocol supports around 4,000 TPs. OmniOne is based on international standards, enabling interoperability as its development has been done in accordance with leading standards. And OmniOne is easy to deploy as node architectures are connected with API. In the next slide, I will show you OmniOne services and that services can be easily deployed in your systems. Simple authentication, combining FIDO-based authentication method with W3C-based decentralized identifiers. Secure identification, facilitating identification process through the use of non-face-to-face identity verification process. Credentials verification, leveraging W3C verifiable credential approach for providing user a new digital ID system. And last but not least, identity of things or IoT, enhancing the security in IoT environments. OmniOne service revolves around the following scheme that follows global standards. OmniOne is based actually on four main components: user, issuer, service provider, and the OmniOne network. Here, to briefly describe the scheme, the user starts by creating his OmniID. When creating OmniID, there will be a generation of a decentralized identifier. This trace identifier will be here stored in the OmniOne network. User now has to create a proof of ID. So for doing so, he will get verified in issuing authority office. So he will go there and will process to what we used to call KYC, like know your customer. Then the issuing authority will provide the user with what we call a verifiable credential, which is a kind of digital credential that is based on data model, based on W3C standard. The issuer then will confirm that he issued this credential by doing a digital signature, by stamping it, let's say, and by recording this verifiable credential, and by recording in the blockchain the issuance information of this verifiable credential. Then the issuing authority, after sending the verifiable credential to the user, user will be able to store this verifiable credential into the secure element of its smartphone. When the user wants to get access to a service, he will then send a verifiable presentation, which is a copy of the VCs plus a proof of control, to the service provider. And the service provider will be able to verify the user by checking the verifiable presentation sent by the user and by leveraging the OmniOne network for being sure that this information has been issued by the issuing authority mentioned into the information provided by the user. After that, if the user is positively verified, the service provider will be able to provide a service to the user. So this is basically the main idea of the OmniOne ecosystem. OmniOne has the potential to address different needs of public institutions and financial organizations. Trusted by Korean government, the technology has the potential to disrupt the global identity market, where a change of identity paradigm is needed. Please contact us if you look for an optimization of your identity system, and we would be pleased to support you in this journey. Coming up next, I will introduce a new use case reflecting the utility of OmniOne in the identity world. Thank you for your attention, and please stay tuned for more information via OmniOne.net. Thank you.